Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? On August 12th, every year, we have one of the most prolific meteor showers that occurs for Earth, and that is the Perseid meteor shower, which means that we have little bits of gravel and sand and dust from Comet Swift-Tuttle that are left over in that orbit of it that went around the sun, and the Earth plows through that stream of material and causes all these wonderful little bits of things to go whoosh, 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 in the sky, kind of like you're seeing on this stellarium rendering here. The great thing about the Perseids is that they happen when it's during a warm month, unlike the other two better meteor showers, the Geminids and the Quadrantids, that occur in December and January. So it's an ideal time for everyone to go outside and look. You don't need a telescope. You don't need binoculars. You can just go outside, look up, and see meteors, which is awesome. It's fun, and you can do it with everyone. So here's the problem with them this year. Unfortunately, the moon is just about full on August 12th. We zoom in on this. We can see what's happening with the moon here. Check that out. It's like, yeah, it's ridiculously full. Illuminated, 95%. So it's practically full. It's going to offer a lot of problems in terms of seeing fainter meteors. So how can we get around this? Well, there's a couple things that we can do. Number one, fortunately, the moon is towards the south. The Perseus constellation is towards the northeast. And although the meteors don't actually appear to come really out of Perseus in the direction of the actual constellation itself, we kind of want to look in like a 45 to 90 degree area around it. We can at least put the moon behind us. So that's number one thing that we can do that'll help, is face away from the moon and then look in the direction that is not where the moon is at, which should help some. That way your eyes will maybe get a few fainter meteors. The Perseids peak at about 90 meteors per hour. So that would be more than one per minute, assuming you could see all 90. However, there's a number of problems with that. One is that moon. Number two is, depending on your local light pollution, you might see way less than that just because you won't be able to see the ones that are fourth, fifth, sixth magnitude. Maybe even have trouble seeing the ones that are third magnitude because those ones will be fairly faint. However, we can see the ones that are brighter, the ones that are second, first, and even brighter than, say, zero magnitude. And we will get a couple of those. We always get a couple of those. You just might not see as many overall meteors as you have in other years when the sky is darker. So one of the things you can do is spend a little longer outside. And the way to do that is, instead of just standing there with your neck craned up like this, hoping to see something in the sky, get comfortable. And I'm going to show you something that can help with that. I have one of these chairs. It's the Nemo Stargaze Recliner Luxury Chair. And I do want to be very clear before I get too far into this. There are two versions of the Stargaze chair. There's the regular recliner chair that doesn't have the headrest thing, and then there's the luxury one that does have the headrest thing. These chairs, by the way, are really great if you want to use binoculars as well, but they're awesome for something like looking at the night sky for things. Thank you, REI. They're awesome for looking at things like meteor showers. Unfortunately, they are kind of expensive. So if you can find one on sale, or if you do want to spend the money on them, they're a great option. Otherwise, you can probably find one of the lounge type chairs at maybe a home improvement store, something like that. So you can lay back on the grass, or even just throw a blanket on the ground with a pillow, cuddle up in a sleeping bag, and stay warm. Because yes, when you're outside at night, especially if you have fewer trees and other things to hold heat, you will get cold. So here's a couple options for that. One is wear a hat. Doesn't hurt. I mean, you will get chillier out there compared to the daytime. So, put the cap on, keep the head warm, wear some clothing that's got longer sleeves on it, and maybe even enjoy a beverage. And I'm going to caution against enjoying the adult beverages. Definitely err on the side of something like coffee or decaf or even hot chocolate, just because the adult beverages that contain alcohol will actually lower your blood temperature a little bit and make you colder. So get something that'll keep you warm, or heck, even if you like soup, you could put soup in there too. So, all those things can help you to be able to see more things up there. Now, you might not see a lot, and that's okay. But there are Perseids to be seen this year. Just employ a few strategies to get you to see the ones that are going to be visible for us this year. And worst case scenario, you can always see some of those Geminids in December or Quadrantids in January, right? No, just the warm weather ones? That's okay. I'm with you on that. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.